chapter 19. Hallelujah. When you have it, say amen.
Amen.
And this is the story about Lot. Amen. Destruction. The destruction of Sodom and Gomorrah. And we see here in I'm going to just drop down to the meat of the matter, down to verse 15. And it says, and when the morning arose, then the angels hastened Lot, saying, arise, take thy wife and thy two daughters, which are here, lest thou be consumed in the iniquity of the city. Read. And it came to pass, when they had brought them forth abroad, that he said, talking about the angel, escape for thy life. Look not behind thee, neither stay thou in all the plain. Escape to the mountain, lest thou be consumed. And then drop down to verse 26. Read. Oh, gracious Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray, Lord, that you anoint our minds and our spirit, and Lord, send us a rhema word, hallelujah, for the house on this day, that we may grow thereby. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. And I want to take a thought from that 26th verse.
Yes.
Don't look back.
Amen.
No looking back. No looking back. Because we are living in what the Bible has declared as the last days. But a lot of people don't really believe that we are. And it's literally evident based on their lifestyle. Based on the way they live, how one thinks that they are living in the last days. Those that believe that we are living in the last days, they trust God. Amen. They believe in the scriptures and trust the true and living God. And they trust what the Lord has said. Here we have in the scriptures a perfect example. A perfect example of the destruction that happened to a city by the name of double cities, by the name of Sodom and Gomorrah. Yeah. And Lot and his family, they lived in this city. Thank you, Lord. They lived in the city of Sodom. And then the city of Sodom was a very wicked city, wherein they lived a lifestyle of sexual perversion,
yes.
Homosexuality, and to just the name of one. And their lifestyle, if you were to look in the book of Genesis chapter 18, wherein the angels had visited Abraham and were telling him that his wife was going to have a baby. Hallelujah. And then Sarah laughed within herself, saying, how shall I have pleasure when I am old? But the angel said to her that thou shalt have a baby by this time next year. And as the angels begin to depart and go to destroy Sodom and Gomorrah, God said, shall I hold anything from my friend Abraham? And God begins to tell Abraham that the judgment has come upon Sodom and Gomorrah because they were a very wicked city. So God is looking and telling Abraham that this is going to happen. And Abraham begins to say, well, God, if there be 50 righteous people in that city, would you spare it? And God said, I shall spare it. And then Abraham dropped down to 40, then dropped down to 30. And by the time he was done, he said, Lord, if there be 10 people in that city, hallelujah, would you destroy it? And God said, if I find 10 righteous in that city, I will not destroy it. Amen. So God and the angels, they left and went to the city of Sodom and Gomorrah. And needless to say, they didn't find 10 righteous people. That's a dangerous thing when you can't find 10 righteous people in a whole city. Hallelujah. So when they came, they found, thank you, Lord, that there was not 10 that was found that was righteous. So Sodom and Gomorrah had to be destroyed. And you can read the story in your own time, but I want to get to the crux of my message here on today. Hallelujah, that when it came time, thank you, Lord, for the city to be destroyed, the angels gathered together. Lot, he told Lot, we need you to gather together your family, gather together your daughters, gather together your wife, and prepare yourself to leave the city. But the Bible tells us a very important thing about Lot. Thank you, Lord, that while the danger was impending, he lingered around the city. Hallelujah. He knew that the city was going to be destroyed, but he decided to linger around. Hallelujah. He decided to stay around for some reason, because there had to be something in Lot. Hallelujah. That wanted him to be a part of the environment that he was in. Hallelujah. But the Bible said plainly in the book of Peter that that city and the things that were going on, it vexed his righteous spirit. Hallelujah. So Lot wanted that city to be saved. Lot wanted that city to be delivered. He wanted the people that are in the city, hallelujah, not to be destroyed. Hallelujah. We all know that it's not God's will that anybody be destroyed. It's not the will of God that people perish. But because people don't hear and take heed and listen to what God has said, that causes the judgment of God to come upon their lives. Oh, I'm preaching right now. Hallelujah. When you don't take heed to what God has said, it puts you in a position, hallelujah, to receive the judgment of God. It's not God's will that anybody should perish, but that all souls come to repentance. But there is a judgment that is coming. Hallelujah. The Bible says it is pointed unto man once to die, and then comes the judgment. Then comes the judgment. Then comes the judgment. There's going to be a day where everybody is judged what they have done in their body. Hallelujah. They cannot escape the judgment that is impending upon their lives if they don't take heed to the plan and to the will of God. Oh my God, I feel like preaching up in here. So God sent an angel. He sent an angel to deliver Lot and his wife, to deliver Lot, his wife, and his children. I've just got to park right here just for a moment. Hallelujah. God sent us an angel, and his name is Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. To help take us, to lead us to escape the impending judgment. So why linger around? Hallelujah. When Jesus came and he died on the cross for all of your sins, why linger around? Hallelujah. When you know that he is the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning in the world. For the Bible says that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. So let me ask you a question. What holds you between two opinions? Are you looking for something better? But there's nobody greater than he. Are you looking for another way out?
the truth and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. There's only one way to salvation. There's a lot of people that say there's a many roads to heaven, but I declare and decree the devil is a liar, because Jesus is the way. You've got to believe on him, as the scriptures have said. So out of your belly can flow rivers of living water. Somebody say amen. Somebody say amen. Somebody say amen. Amen to the truth. So in the story on today, hallelujah, the angels came to lead Lot and his family out to a safe place. Somebody say a safe place. And as they were before they were going, the angel gave explicit instructions. He told them not to look back. And he said, and it came to pass when they came forth out of the broad to escape for their life. He told them to escape for your life and not to look back. Don't look behind me. Neither stay in this place. He told them to escape to the mountains, lest thou be consumed. So the angel gave explicit instructions for them to leave the place of destruction, for them to leave the place that was about to be consumed, and told them, don't look back. And as they went and as they go, the Bible says that Lot's wife, she looked back, and the Bible said that she was turned into a pillar of salt. Well, we can gather together a lot of scholars in the place, and we could give a lot of reasons why Lot's wife looked back. Hallelujah. But Jesus, he made it plain in his epistle or in his gospel. He was talking about we're living in the last days. Hallelujah. And in the last days, people are going to be consumed with the duties and the affairs of this life. Hallelujah. People are going to be consumed. Hallelujah. With life and working. They're going to be more consumed about how they look and what they are doing, and not paying attention that there is a thief that is coming in the night, that judgment is on the way. So he told them, remember Lot's wife. A lot of people like to live in their past. Tell your neighbor, don't look back. Don't look back. The Bible says that he that taketh his hand, putteth his hands to the plow, and looketh back, he is not fit for the kingdom of heaven. You can't look back. If you look back, look back on what you used to do. Look back on your glory days. You know how we are. We can glorify our sinful days. We can glorify our party days. We can look and look back on the time when we were at the club and having a good old time on the dance floor. I remember I used to do the bumps. I used to do the hops. I used to do the gigolo and get down on the dance floor listening to my favorite music. Hallelujah, she is a brick house. And those thoughts in my mind cause me to look back. Look back and wonder, where did those times go? And then I'll see you today. I see you popping, I see you skipping, I see you dancing. Why are you skipping and popping and dancing now? It's because you look back. You were thinking about when you used to be in the 80s. But honey, let me tell you, you in the 2018 now. And you let all those things go. Don't the lust of the eyes, and the pride of mind. If you're going to look back on the power that God gave to you to overcome the enemy. Come on and give God a praise. Come on and give God a praise. To the neighbor, I won't look back. I won't look back. I'm walking by faith and not by sight. I'm laying hold on that eternal life. The Lord, and give God a praise. Don't look back. Y'all may be seated. Is there one here today? Short